Welcome back to Creepy Crawlers Garage and another daily update. We're going to take a look at what's going on with the TRXZ project and what's up with the new cinematic series that's coming to the channel. So don't go anywhere. So I finished up the rocket launcher in the back cage of the TRXZ project, and then I wanted to show you guys it actually worked because it'll rotate, but I ran into a bit of a problem because something in the electrical system of the TRX-4 base that we're using for this, building this off of, isn't working. I don't know if it's the receiver, but what I really think is it's the battery. I think my one Traxxas battery has gone bad. I tried putting it on the charger and it didn't seem to want to take a charge, so I think it's just gone bad. And it's the only Traxxas, the only battery with a Traxxas connector I have on it. So what I did as a quick fix, just to be able to show you guys this work, is I backed up the old shop truck up to it here, plugged into its first channel, so that now you can see the that we can move the rocket launcher back here. So Bunny actually works. Let me see if I can turn it a little more for you, just so you can see. And basically, I'm just using the first channel on off the shop truck to make this happen. But we'll do this off like a third channel or something like that when it comes time. But yeah, anyway, so there it is. It's actually working. So let me turn this stuff off and then we'll take a look at how we got it working. Here's Bunny, the rocket launcher for the back of the TRXZ project, out of the cage and sitting on its new base. It's very simple how we got it to work. Let me go ahead and pop the rocket launcher off. And you can see that we just have a servo horn that's screwed on to the rocket launcher itself. And then, like we had seen before, we had a plate. This is what it rotates on. We got a servo that's mounted in here. Basically, I just boxed in off the bottom of this plate, making sure that it would fit into the cage. And then I just built some brackets across. You can see I completely squared in the servo, this little micro servo, to make sure it sits nice and firm in there. So we've got the two braces that run this way that it screws to, and then two braces that run this way that sandwich it in on the skinny sides. But anyway, so it's just that simple. And then I ran the servo wire just out the front, and then that'll go into the cab once we get the electronics on the TRX-4 actually working. But that's all it took to basically get and I left it like this, where it'll just pop on and off, and that's all it takes to get the rocket launcher into the box it goes. It's just very simple. Let me know what you think down in the comment section, but I think it's going to work pretty well. And the last update I wanted to talk about with the TRXZ project is I've started working on the rear windows that we had spoke about last episode. So basically, I've gone ahead and laminated the rear windows with the diamond plate styrene. They'll get the full weathering effect, just like the rest of the diamond plate, have not done that yet. And then, of course, they're going to get hinged in the front so that they pop open backwards, like so. So I've got to do that yet. I'll probably try to get that done later this evening. I had to stop and film this update for you guys, but that'll probably get done this evening where they'll get hinged and you know what? Now that I think about it, I'm not going to be able to fully weather that because I actually ran out of the black paint I'm using on the diamond plate. So I got to order that up. But anyways, I'll go ahead and get the hinge set up for it. And then also, I thought we'd go ahead and start working on the front lights too. I don't know if you noticed last episode, but I had the clear lenses in. Well, what I think I'm going to do, or what I have done, is laminated those with the diamond plate also. Let me swing over that way. Obviously, these will get painted black and everything else also. I'm going to be putting a light kit in this, so we'll have two lights that'll be shining out here. And what I think I'm going to do is just drill a series of small holes in the top and bottom so that the light will kind of shine through. And then once this is mounted in here, let me see if I can get them in real quick. Once these are mounted in here, it'll be like diamond plate armor for our lights. And then of course, we're gonna have that big plow type bumper up front. And what I think I'll do is probably cut a hole in the bumper where the light will shine through. And then we're also gonna have the lights up top. But as far as the actual headlights on the truck, I think that's how we're gonna work that. I think it'll look pretty cool. Let me know what you think down in the comment section. If you have a better idea for the headlights, let me know what you think. But I think that's gonna look pretty good. It's gonna look like we put some diamond plate on there and then just kind of drilled holes into it so that the headlights will shine through. And then I think with the holes in the bumper too, that'll just really complete the look. I think that'll look pretty good. But let me know what you think down in the comment section. So that's where we are with the TRX-Z project right now. But I wanted to talk to you guys real quickly about the new series that we were talking about yesterday. And what I'm calling it cinematic run videos. So what the idea is, and I had some comments about it, but the idea is that they're basically run videos, but with a story. So for example, and the example that was actually given in the comments yesterday, which is a good one, is the new shop truck has to go out on a parts run or on a mission and then get back to the shop. So basically it'd be a run video with cinematics, with characters, using stop motion, just like we do with Frank and that kind of thing. And it's a mission where they've got to go out, achieve something and come back, for example. So with that said, there's going to be a lot of work that goes into this. There's going to be a lot that needs to go into this. It's a big project because not only do we have to finish the shop truck, but I'm going to have to we've got two other trucks that we're going to be included, a truck and the Dodge, or I guess a VW Beetle and a Dodge. And then there'll probably will be other trucks that we're going to have to incorporate in. There's a lot of characters that are going to be incorporated. So we're going to have Frank and some other characters that'll be working in the shop in year 3000 AD. And then we're going to have the other side too. So whether it's the zombies, or I think there's going to be competing shops out in the world. So we'll call the bad guys, which we'll come up with a name for. So the point being is there's going to be a lot of work that goes into this. I'm going to have to build sound stages for this because I think I'm going to have to build a whole new shop because I want it to be apocalyptic. I want it to be almost cyberpunkish, probably something to that effect. I think this is going to all have a very cyberpunk feel. So, I think that's kind of the feel we'll probably go with. And then I'm going to have to build other building fascias. So when I say a soundstage, so it might be a street that the trucks need to drive down, and you're going to have the fascias of this old rundown downtown, something like that. And then I'm going to have to go out and scout some locations too, because I want to do outdoor shots too, where they're out, say in a riverbed or something. So anyways, the point being is there's going to be a lot of work to this. So it could be a lot of fun, and I'm going to need a lot of ideas from you guys to go along with it. And then I'm also think I'm going to have, because there's going to be, I hate talking about this, and I know you guys hate hearing about it, but there's going to be a money aspect to this. It's going to cost money. It's not going to be cheap to do. So what I think I'm going to do is over at the Patreon page is add some benefits to a few of the levels that can make you producers. So what that means is at certain levels, and I think it'll start at Explorer level and then higher, which I already have a lot of Explorer level patrons. So you guys are already in. You don't have to do anything. And then but I might do some higher tiers too for producer level. So in other words, it'll make you a producer or maybe even an executive producer. And what that's going to get you for sure is at the beginning of every episode of the series, you're going to get producer credit. So at the very beginning, when it opens up, you're going to get produced by, boom, and it's going to be you guys. And then at the end, it'll be executive producer in that level. And then I think I'm going to come up with some other ideas too that'll give you benefits, like maybe names. So we're going to need names for a lot of characters in these episodes. And if you so choose, maybe either I can just directly use your name as the character, or you could give me the name to use for that character, things like that. So some extra creative stuff that you'll get by being at those producer levels or at those certain levels over at the Patreon page. Anyways, I don't want to go on too much about it because I know a lot of you guys hate hearing about it. But if it's something you're interested in, I'll mention this again probably tomorrow. So give me this evening and I'll put that stuff together over at the Patreon page. Then probably tomorrow, go check it out. I'll remind you tomorrow also in the daily update. But go check it out. Maybe it's something you're interested in and a way that you'd like to support these series and this channel. Just go check it out. There's the direct link down in the description if you're interested in that. But this is going to be a lot of fun. I'm going to have a lot of fun with it, just building the trucks, building the sets, building the sound stages, actually producing, editing it. It's going to be a lot of fun. Let me know what you think. Obviously, I'm going to need ideas too from you guys that are watching. And don't worry, all of this is going to be on YouTube. So the end results all on YouTube. Nothing's going to be on Patreon behind the scenes, behind the paywall. The only thing that's going to be behind the paywall is some little extra benefits that you could get, like having your name in the episodes and maybe some naming rights and these kind of things. But the series itself will be free to everybody, free to all you guys here on the YouTube channel. So don't worry about that. I want to make that very clear. You're not going to miss anything that's going to be going on with it, along with the daily updates that are going to continue happening. So you're going to get to see the trucks built. You're going to be able to give input just like you already are on the building of the trucks, the building of the cities, even storylines. If you have ideas, let me know. I might use them. I'll be coming up with my own storylines too. But anyways, just wanted to give you the updates on that. We're right here at the base level. So you guys are starting right in the beginning. It would be a lot of fun. Leave me your comments down below. Let me know what you think. Hit that like button. It really does help in the YouTube algorithms. And if this is something you want to keep up with and interested in here on the YouTube channel, make sure and hit that subscribe button. Thank you guys for joining me today. And I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.